Hey gang, the comic collector has started a tag. He has 25 questions to determine whether or not you are a comic book nerd. The first question is, have you ever nitpicked a book over its condition? Absolutely, and in fact, I regret one of them. It was a 1977 Red Sonja number one in the quarter bin that looked like it was maybe in fine condition, but I turned it around and there's a sizable hole that goes all the way through the book to the cover, and there was a slight indent on the cover that I noticed after that. And my attitude was, well, someone else can have this dud. I'd rather have the quarter, but I certainly regret it because there's a hashtag on Instagram that is nowhere near Mint Monday, and that would be fun to show the cover that looks like a fine copy and then turn it around to show the hole in it. Number two, have you ever sniped anyone on eBay? I'm sure that I have, but I actually wouldn't know about it because I had a sniping service when I was hardcore into eBay. It would automatically put in your highest bid at the last like quarter second. Number three, have you ever paid over a hundy for a book or just gone over budget? No, and I wish I could. I wish I could say, wait, just hold on to this book. I got to run to the ATM. I got to get some cash and I'll be right back. It's never happened. The books I see are just lame or in sucky condition. Number four, have you ever complained about specking or flipping? I will say yes, even though it's really just good-natured goofing, because I'm fully aware that comic books are collectibles. The reason they still make them like they did in the 40s is because they're so fragile. They're so easily VF'd up, which makes them more collectible. Number five, have you ever given or received a comic as a gift? I have given comics as gifts, and my sister will try to find stuff for me for my birthday or Christmas, and this birthday she got me an oversized Archie Digest and a really oversized Complete Cartoons of the New Yorker. Number six, as an adult, have you ever decorated your home in comic paraphernalia? No. Like, I don't have a man cave or even a dedicated comic book room. Number seven, have you ever skipped work to read or buy comics? No. Number eight, have you ever paid to go to a con? I will say yes to this because I have paid to go to shows, but I've never gone to a proper cosplayer-infested con. Number nine, have you ever paid to get an autograph, photo, or sketch? No. Number 10, have you ever bought multiple copies of a book? If you mean a new book, I've only been able to do that once, though I would do it more. I bought a few copies of the sketch cover of Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number one off the shelf. Lord knows why my shop had ordered them. Number 11, have you ever bought multiple covers of a book? Yes, though not off the rack in back issues, but you know, it's the same thing. Number 12, have you ever complained you need to downsize your collection for space? I'm surprised I haven't done it so far on this video. Number 13, have you ever sent a book in for grading? No. Number 14, have you ever sent in a book for cleaning or pressing? I have not, though I do have a free press from He's Got Freaking Issues. I don't know what book I'd send to him, though. Number 15, have you ever bought chases or store exclusives? No. Number 16, have you ever traded comics? No. Number 17, have you ever waited to get tickets to a comic book movie? No. I have seen two comic book movies in the theater, Thor and Avengers, and there was no lineup. There was barely anyone in the theater for Thor. Number 18, have you ever gotten into a fight or physical altercation because of comics? No, indeed. Number 19, have you ever trolled online or got into a post-war over comics? I've never sought out a fight. I've never trolled anyone. But man, if you have an opinion on a message board, you have to put up a fight for it. And we're not talking about being trolled by just anonymous nubbins, though that obviously constantly happens. I had to fight with like Brett Booth and Kim Thompson. It's like, don't you people have jobs? And at first I took it personally, like, why me? Why me? Why did it have to be me? But I quickly realized that they're just adhering very closely to the Resentful Nubbin Handbook. It's like there's a Four Dummies handbook on being a fruitcake on the internet. Chapter 1, how to accuse a complete stranger of being a fraud. Number 20, have you ever dressed up as an adult as a comic book character? No. Number 21, have you ever lied about collecting comics? I probably should, because the look on girls' faces when I say I collect comics is like, bye, take care, brush your hair. Number 22, have you ever flipped or specced on a book? I used to flip books all the time, and I actually regret flipping some of them because there was a bunch of like spawns I would have loved to have kept, but I never would have bought them except to flip them. And I do try to spec whenever I can. Number 23, have you ever bought a figure or statue of a comic character? No statues, but I do have a couple of the modern action figures. Number 24, have you ever cried or been angry over reading a comic? Yes, there's very sad scenes in Cerebus. And finally, number 25, do you have a comic-related tattoo? I do. I've got Grant Morrison on my ballsack. He's lefty. So thank you to the comic collector. Thank you for this tag. I'll have your link in the description. And I will tag Unruly Simeon, Genome Presents, Sleepy Reader 666, Matilda Gothica, and Wednesday's Serial. And I'll have all of their links in the description. So I scored 13 out of 25. I can't do quick math, but I think that makes me a comic book nerd. Which makes good sense. I always figured that would be the case.